गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स.
गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
ऑडिबिलिटी इज ओके?
यस सर.
सो वेलकम टू द कोर्स मैथ F212 ऑप्टिमाइजेशन. सो एज द नेम प्रॉम्प्ट यू, हियर वी हैव टू डू द ऑप्टिमाइजेशन, मीन्स समथिंग वी हैव टू ऑप्टिमाइज अंडर द कंस्ट्रेंट. So here we have the handout. Here we have the handout for this course. So myself, Chandrasekhar, the IC for this. I am professor in the Department of Mathematics. Along with me, Dr. Rakhi and Dr. C.V. Agarwal, the team member. So here, this is the textbook authored by H.A. Taha, Operation Research and Introduction. It is the publication of the Pearson Education, 9th edition. Following are the good reference book which you can consult during your studies. So, in the very first lecture, we will start with the introduction optimization. What is the optimization problem? Then we will see the different type of the optimization problem. So in that, first we will cover the two variable problem, then its solution by graphical method, then we will go for the simplex method, their special cases, right there. Then after we extend for the dual problem, then we have the other methods, other simple or means special cases of the simplex method, then post-optimal analysis, then application of the linear program, transportation and assignment problem. Then we have the goal programming. Then we have the integer programming. So these all are the linear program. Thereafter, we have the non-linear program. In the non-linear program, we will see the constraint and unconstrained problem. Then a special case, we will study the quadratic programming. And at last, we will study the non-conventional optimization technique, and genetic algorithm is in your course. So here we have the evaluation component. So this time we have the mid-semester and comprehensive with weightage 35% and 45%. This is not final. Actually, ASD will give the some other instruction, then we will change this. Right, so later on, I will tell you what will be the exact, right, what will be the exact percentage or dates and other things, syllabus, everything. Right, and we will, we have the 20% continuous evaluation also at present, but whatever the final, I will tell you later. So this is the, and as you know, we provide the makeup for the regular exam if we have any genuine case. All the notice I will provide on the Nalanda regarding the course. Chamber consultancy, I will announce later on. So, anything you want to ask about the course? Anyone? Audio video is okay? Or is there any time lag?
It's fine, sir.
Any curiosity about the course? Anything you want to ask? So great, there is no doubt. So let us start with the first chapter, chapter one. So what is the operation research? So actually it is not very old mathematics. It is not very old mathematics. It was initiated in the World War II only. in England. At that time, the scientists have given you how to utilize the war material, the war resource, right? Scientifically, in the scientific way, so that you can optimize the available resource. So after the success of the World War II, they found its success in every sphere of the life. So that's why it got the very affection in mathematics, right? So here in this chapter, we will study some basic terms of the operation research, including mathematical modeling, feasible solution, optimization, iterative computation. So as you know, for anything, first we have to model mathematically. So mathematical modeling is an important thing. So whatever the science, everywhere the mathematical modeling is important thing. So here also mathematical modeling is cornerstone of the OR. In this case, whatever the abstract properties, intangible or unquantifiable factors such as human behavior must be accounted for in the final decision. Means whenever we have any solution, any decision, we have to take the decision among the constraints. So at that time, we have to take care about the abstract things also. Then only your decision will be the beneficial or good. So when we have to make the problem, so we have to recognize the few things. What are the decision alternatives? From where we have to take the decision? What are the alternatives are available to us? Under what restriction is the decision we have to make? Right? So, means, is there any restriction or not? Then we have to decide what is the objective criteria. What we have to maximize, what we have to minimize. So that we have to decide. So after recognizing all these, we can formulate. Let us understand this by the example. So this is from your book. So imagine that you have the 5-week business commitment between the Factively and the Denver. You fly out the Factively on Monday and return on the Wednesday days. A regular round trip ticket cost $400, but 20% discount is guaranteed if the dates of the ticket span a weekend. A one-way ticket is either direction cost 75% of the regular price. How should you buy the ticket for the 5-week period? So in this question, here we have to purchase the ticket for the trip. So in this, we have the following alternatives. So what we can do, either we can buy the 5 tickets of the regular trip, right? Of FYV to Dan to FYV, right? For departure on Monday and return on Wednesday of the same week. Otherwise, what we can do? We can do buy 1 ticket for FYV to Dan and 4th round ticket from Dan to FYV and Dan that spend the weekends and 1 Dan to FYV. Then after, we can purchase another alternative can be, we can purchase the ticket of FYV, Dan FYV to cover the Monday of the first week and Wednesday of the last week. And 4 for the Dan FYV, Dan FYV to Dan to cover the remaining legs. All tickets in this alternative span at least 1 weekend. So we have the following alternatives after considering the discount and all these things. And what is the restriction? You have to go on Monday from the FYV and you have to return on Wednesday. That is our restriction. So first we have to recognize what are the alternatives, what are the restrictions. So for these alternatives, we can have the cost like this. So total cost for the whole month will be the $2,000, will be the $1,880 and $1,600. So what is the objective? Always, as a tourist, what will be the objective? To minimize the total cost. So what we will consider? We will consider the minimum cost. So right, so we will consider the this minimum cost. So this is the objective. So here you have seen that in the question I have told you, for each question we have to recognize what are the alternatives, right? Is there any restriction or not? Then what is the objective criteria? Accordingly, we have to determine the solution. So for the given question, we have recognized the following alternatives and the following restriction. Then we quantify the alternatives in terms of the cost, and among the cost we have the $1,600 as a minimum cost. So in this case, you have seen we have the finite number of alternatives, but always we haven't such thing. So let us have another example. Consider forming a maximum area rectangle out of the piece of the wire of length capital L. So we have the wire of the capital length L, and we have to make the rectangle of the side AB, you can consider. What should be the width and height of the rectangle? So already you have done this question in class 8th, 9th. So in this case, we can have what alternative we can have? We can take any width, any height, under the constraint that width of rectangle plus height of the rectangle should be the half of the length of the wire. And width and height cannot be the negative. So, and restriction is here we can translate mathematically as a twice of the width plus height is equal to L, and width and height must be the non-negative. Right? So this is the non-negative. Non-negative. So now what is the objective? So here the objective is to maximize the area. So area of the rectangle can be given by the Z is equal to W into H. So this is the way to write the problem. And you know that the rectangle has maximum area when W is equal to H is equal to L by 4. Means for the square, we can have infinitely many rectangle with this constraint that total length is capital L. So here you can see we can have the infinitely many alternatives. So out of that, you have to choose the best one. So from here, you can conclude that the structure of optimization problem will be the maximize or minimize the objective function subject to constraint. So this is the way to write what we have to optimize, that we write as a objective function subject to constraint. Constraint means alternatives and the restrictions. So from here, from this given problem, we have to determine the solution. So next will be the type of the solution, right? So here we have seen the solution is square. Here we have seen the solution is $1,600, right? So here we have to determine the solution. So solution, we have the two type of the solution. First one is feasible solution, another one is the optimal solution. So feasible solution is the solution which satisfy all the constraints, that will be the feasible solution. And optimal solution is the feasible solution which maximize or minimize the objective function. Means which optimize the objective function. So optimal solution is the feasible solution which optimize the objective function, right? And feasible solution is the solution which satisfy the all the constraints. So that solution we have to determine in this course. So for the different type of the problem, we have the different type of the solution methodology. We have the different type of the approach to solve, to represent. So means we haven't the single technique or single general technique, right, to solve all kind of the optimization problem. So we have the different type of the solution technique. So here we have the some list of the optimization problem, linear programming, where we have constraints of nature linear, means constraints and objective function, when the constraints and objective function both are linear in nature, then we say it is of linear programming. Integer programming, it is a special case of the linear programming. Here we have the constraint that decision variables are integer in nature, then we say it is the integer programming. Then the dynamic programming, in the dynamic programming we break the our given problem into the various sub problems, and optimal solution of the first problem will be the input for the second problem. Optimal solution of the second problem will be the input for the third problem, and so on. And at last, we will get the optimal solution for the complete problem. When we are in the nth stage, so we will use the optimal solution of the n minus 1th stage, and the solution of the nth stage will give you the optimal solution of the complete problem. So that is the dynamic programming. In the network programming, we represent the problem with the help of the network, and we try to determine the optimal scheduling. So queuing models generally define for the waiting line problem, and simulation model means whenever the model is very complex, existing analytical methods are not competent to solve the given problem, then we will go for the simulation model, right? Simulation technique, where we mimic the problem, and from the mimicry, from the imitation, whatever the solution we are getting, we try to estimate the required things. So that is the simulation model. So in our course, in the present course, we have the linear program, integer program, right, nonlinear program. These programs are the part of the operation research. We have the two courses here in BITS on the optimization. One is this optimization, another one is the 242 operation research. The basic difference between these two courses are, here whatever the model we consider, all are deterministic in nature, and whatever the problem we consider in the course operation research, that will be of probabilistic in nature, right? That is the basic difference. Here we have considered for differentiating between the optimization and operation research. By nature, both are the same thing. Only the difference is, here we haven't the involvement of the any probability theory, and there all the models required, means all the models are stochastic in nature. They are random in nature. Now, here for the each model, we have the set algorithm. So we will go with those algorithm. If algorithm is not fit for the particular problem, if algorithm is not fit, then we will go with the heuristic method. Heuristic method means we assume some solution and then check whether that solution is suitable or not. So that is the direct search method. Means we hypothetically consider some solution, then we check one by one all the solution. So that is very tedious. Means we can have the infinitely many solution also. So always we have to go with the some algorithmic method way, right, to determine the solution. Heuristic method is the last tool. Whenever we haven't the solution, so with the heuristic method, you cannot guarantee about the optimal solution. I have made the WhatsApp group. So those who have not joined, please join from the link. So if any information, I can provide on that also. So in the chatting, I have given you the link. You can join the WhatsApp group. Or you can scan the QR code from here. Let us check whether we can paste the QR code in the no. So from here. Otherwise, I have given you on the mail also. From there, you can do. Let us continue. So, as I have told you, in every optimization problem, main thing is how good you have done your modeling. So here, the modeling is the art, right? So in this case, naturally, everything you cannot model. As I have told you, the abstract thing you have to quantify. So naturally, when we are quantifying the abstract thing, then you cannot quantify in 100% way. So here we have to convert our real problem into the right assumed real world problem. So here abstract the assumed real world from the real situation by concentrating on the dominant variable. Means we have to concentrate on the dominant variable that control the behavior of the real system. Then the model express in an amenable manner the mathematical function that represent the behavior of the assumed real world. Means whatever the real world situation, first we abstract into the assumed real problem and then we determine the when then we determine the mathematical model. From here we determine the solution, then we implement the solution, and during the implementation we can have some problem, right? Or during the decision, you can say some decision we have to take. So this decision may be suitable, may not be suitable. So again you have to rethink. So that is the way of modeling. So this optimization means it is not necessary always for all the problem we can have the mathematical model. We should go for the mathematical modeling, or we should go for the for the optimization technique. There are lot of problem which you can solve just by the judgment, just by seeing. For example, if we have the long queue, right? If we have the long waiting queue in the barber shop, so how you can solve, how you can reduce the queue, or how you can engage the person? So generally we have the big mirror in the barber shop. So that big mirror is just to engage you, right? Those mirror are just to engage you, means you are engaging yourself, right, by seeing your face, your beauty. So generally you do not bother about the time. In the lift, in the front of the lift, always you have seen we have the big mirror, just to avoid the long waiting time in the elevator, in the lift, right? Whenever you have to wait for the lift, so there they have the big mirror. So there you are engaging yourself on looking the your beauty. So this is the solution of the real problem. So here we have not used any queuing model. So there are the lot of things where just by judgment you can solve that problem, need not to go for the mathematical modeling or for the optimization technique. Phases of an OR study. So whatever the problem, whether the probabilistic or deterministic, always we have to define the problem first, then we have to make the mathematical model, then we have using some better optimization technique or suitable optimization technique, we have to determine the solution, then whether that solution is valid for the given problem or not, then we will implement that solution. So these are the phases of any OR study. For example, as I have told you, one structure of the problem, but that structure need not to be true for the all problem. For example, in a baseball game, Jim is the pitcher and Joe is the batter. Suppose that Jim can throw either a fast or the curve ball at random. If Joe correctly predicts a curve ball, he can maintain 0.5 batting average. Else, if Jim throws the curve ball, the Joe prepares for fast ball. His batting average is kept down to 0.200. On the other hand, if Joe correctly predicts the fast ball, he gets 0.300 batting average. Else, his batting average is only 0.100. So in this case, we have to recognize the alternatives. We have to see the restriction, but way of representation may be the different. So here we have the alternatives for the Joe, prepare for the curve or the fast ball. For the Jim, throw curve or the fast ball. So in this case, we have the representation of the problem like this. So here we have written, right? Written the cases when the Joe throw the curve or fast. So whether the Jim predict the correctly or not, right? So in this case, Joe tries to improve the betting score and Jim tries to counter the Joe's action by selecting a less favorable strategy. Means in this problem, we have not to optimize anything. Just we have to counter the opponent. Right? Just we have to counter the opponent. Means this is the game problem. This is the game theory. This is the game problem. In this case, both player wants to win. Right? But overall, there is no maximization, no minimization. So we can have such kind of the problem also in the optimization. So this is the basic. So in quiz time, we may ask few things from the first chapter. So important chapter is the now chapter 2, modeling with the linear programming. As I have told you, we have the different type of the linear different type of the programming or different type of the OR problem. So very first or and easy one is the linear programming. Linear programming means objective function and constraints both are linear in nature. Then we will see, first we will see what is the linear programming. Then we will see how we can solve the linear programming. So here, this chapter concentrates on the model formulation and computation in linear programming. Commonly, we call it as a LPP, linear programming problem, or LPM problem. It starts with the modeling and graphical solution. Right? This chapter, we start with the modeling, how we can write the problem. Then its graphical solution, which will be the base for which will be the base for the analytical solution of the bigger problem. So here we start with the two variable problem. So this section deals with the two variable problem, but we know that hardly we will get the confront with the two variable problem, but this will give the base for the bigger or complex problem. So here we have the formulation. We start with the formulation of linear program with the two variable problem. So this section deals with graphical solution of two variable LP. Though the two variable problem hardly exists in practice, the treatment provides the concrete foundation for the development of the general simplex algorithm. So analytical method to solve the linear program is the simplex method. So what is the procedure in the simplex method? That we can understand from the procedure of the graphical solution. And graphical solution is suitable for the two variable problem only. So first we will see what is the two variable problem. So here, very first problem, and this is the most important problem. This problem I will use in the next 30 lecture. Right? Just I will tell you the Redi-Mic problem. So you have to recognize this problem, right? So it is a very means important problem. So see carefully. Redi-Mic produces both interior and exterior paints from the two raw material M1 and M2. Few of you may already have done the linear program formulation in the 12th also. So Redi-Mic produces the two interior and exterior paints from the two raw materials M1 and M2. The following table provides the basic data of the problem. So here, raw materials are given to you in tons. So raw materials is given to you. It is available 24 ton and the 6 ton. Out of these, per ton, you can produce the exterior paint as a 6 ton and interior paint as a 4 ton. And from the material 2, you can produce 1 ton of the exterior paint and 2 ton of the interior paint. And you can sell out in $5,000, right, per ton of the exterior paint and interior paint in rupee in dollar 4,000.
we have some more restrictions. A market survey indicates that daily demand for interior paint cannot exceed that of the exterior paint by more than 1 ton. Also, the maximum daily demand for interior paint is 2 ton. Ready mix want to determine optimal product mix, means how much the interior or exterior paint the company should manufacture to maximize the total profit. So in this case, we have to recognize what are the alternatives, what are the constraints, right? What is the objective function? So for that, first we have to write the what is the appropriate decision variable. Decision variable is the most important thing. If you recognize the, if you identify the decision variable correctly, so half question you have solved. So in this case, as I have told you, first we have to recognize the decision variable. Then we write what is the goal, what is the objective function, whether we have to do the maximization or minimization. So some judgmental decision we have to take. If it is the profit, then we have to maximize. If it is the cost, then we have to minimize. Then what is the constraints? So here the decision variable we assume as a x1 is equal to ton produced daily for the exterior paint. Daily production of the exterior paint we represent by the x1, and daily production of interior paint we represent by the x2. So in this case, it is given to you that profit in selling the exterior paint is $5,000, and corresponding to interior paint the profit is $4,000. So here we have to, so total profit means 5x1 will be the profit from the exterior paint, and 4x2 will be the profit from the interior paint, and total profit will become the 5x1 plus 4x2, right? So, and now it is a profit, so we have to maximize this. So maximize z is equal to 5x1 plus 4x2. Then consumption of the material 1, right? Material M1, right? Total availability is the 24. For producing a ton exterior paint, we require the 6 ton of the material 1, right? And for the interior paint, we require the 4 ton. So here means total utilization of the material 1 is the 6-1 in producing the exterior paint, and total utilization of the material M1 in producing the interior paint will be the 4x2. So 6x1 plus 4x2 will be the total utilization of material M1 in producing the exterior paint and interior paint in quantity x1 and x2. And maximum daily availability is the 24. So you cannot utilize more than the daily availability. You cannot utilize more than the daily availability. So here we have the constraint, right? This is the constraint corresponding to M1. This is the constraint corresponding to M1. So this is the restriction of availability of the material M1. Only 4 ton for daily it is available. You have to balance the utilization between exterior paint and the interior paint, and their consumption, their utilization is given to you here. In the table, the similar data we have for the material M2 also. So raw material M2, total availability or maximum availability is the 6 ton. And in production of the exterior paint, its requirement is 1 ton. and for the interior paint, its requirement is the 2 ton. It means total consumption of the material M2 for producing the exterior paint will be the X1, and for producing the interior paint, it will become the 2X2, right? And total consumption for the material M2 will be the X1 plus 2X2. And we know that maximum availability for a day, it is the 6 ton. So that is the second constraint. So this constraint corresponding to the M2, material M2. Then after, we have another restriction, a market survey indicates that daily demand for interior paint cannot exceed that for exterior paint by more than 1 ton. Daily demand of the interior paint cannot exceed, means interior paint demand is the whatever you have X2, cannot exceed than the X1, right? More than a ton means it is the less than 1, right? Less than 1 or less than equal to 1. So in this case, here we have this constraint minus X1 plus X2 less than equal to 1. So here we, whatever the constraint we are getting, always we write the X1 in one line, X2 in another line. Then after, another constraint is also the maximum daily demand for interior paint is 2 ton. So maximum daily demand for the interior paint. Interior paint means here we have the X2. X2 cannot be more than the 2 tons. X2 cannot be the more than 2 ton. So here we have the X2 less than equal to 2. So this is the market constraint and this is the demand constraint. So we write all the constraints, and naturally when we have the production, you cannot produce in negative. So always it is mandatory, it is very, very important to add the non-negativity restriction. This we called a non-negativity restriction. Non-negativity restriction means we cannot produce the exterior paint and interior paint in negative, right? Or either it is zero or positive. So always in the linear program, it is mandatory to add the non-negative restriction. So here, now, what is the feasible solution? So as I have told you, this is the non-negative restriction. So this is the restriction. Means here we have the total 5 restrictions. Here we have the total 5 restrictions. So the solution, which satisfy all these restrictions or all these constraints, we call the feasible solution. Feasible solution. Any solution which is not able to satisfy anyone, then we call that as a non-feasible solution. And the feasible solution which give the maximum value of the objective function will be known as the optimal solution. So that we have to determine. So any doubt in the formulation of this problem, anything you want to re-explain or revisit? Anyone? Anything you want to revisit? So how you will recognize whether the given problem is linear program or not? So in that problem, we have to see the following properties. So first one is the proportionality. So actually in this case, we have seen X1 is proportional, right? X2 is proportional. So we have added the constraint of the proportionality. x1 is proportional, x2 is proportional in the constant, and we have added the constant of the proportionality. X1 is proportional, x2 is proportional, we have added the constant of the proportionality. Means it must satisfy in the objective function and in the constant, it must satisfy the property of the proportionality. This property requires the contribution of each decision variable in both objective function and the constant to be directly proportional to the value of the variable. Then after, we must have the additivity. So here we have seen, we have the additivity, we have the additivity, right? We have the additivity. Means in the constraint, in the objective function, we have the additivity of the decision variables. So here, additivity, this property requires the total contribution of all variables in the objective function and in the constraint to be direct sum of the individual contribution of each variable. Then, most important, certainty. All the objective, and constant coefficient of the linear program be the deterministic. Here you can see the 5 is deterministic, 4 is deterministic, certain, 6 is deterministic, 4 is deterministic, 1 is deterministic, 2 is deterministic. Means these constant should be the fixed. These values should be the fixed, these values should be the certain. So all the objective and the constraints of LP model are deterministic. This means that they are known constants, a rare occurrence in a real life where the data are more likely to be represented by the probabilistic distribution. Now we have the methodology for the probabilistic coefficient also, but in your course we have only the deterministic. And so these are the property of the LP model. Every LP problem, linear programming problem, must satisfy the proportionality, additivity, and certainty in objective function and the constraint. Any doubt? So let us stop here. In next class, we will do this question.
So,
yes.
Could you please explain the proportionality property once again?
I'm saying that here when we are writing the 5x1, so this is the decision variable. So whatever its role, it is giving in the objective function. Means this much profit I can share. This decision variable is saying that this much profit I can share, right? And we know that for each turn we have the this property certain. So total contribution of the first decision variable will be the 5x1. So that is the proportionality. This property required this okay.
Yes, sir.
So generally in quiz we ask this question, what are the properties of the LP model? Write the properties of the LP model. So you have to write these terms only, proportionality, additivity, and certainty. Any other doubt? So video will be available. I will give you the link where it will be available.
So will the slides be shared?
No, slide will not be shared.
Okay, sir.
Only video I will provide. Any other doubt? So have a nice day.